First of all, I want to say one thing to all you people sitting around here doing this and watching this and going on the live stream here. We actually went on a live stream all the way from Los Angeles to Las Vegas. We took approximately 300 to 400 people with us at one time driving down here. Well, halfway there, the vehicle starts to break down, and I just start saying, I've seen this movie before. I got all this negativity. All this negativity from you people saying that I was some sort of jinx or some sort of whatever. I was talking to myself, and I was saying to myself, I said, you know something, I need to go to Vegas. I'm going to sell my thing that holds the drumsticks on the snare drum thing or something like that. And it was something that I have invented and put time and effort and monies into, and I have people I've called in requests from people who owe me favors. That's right. I come from real show business a long time ago, something you people have never heard of. That's right. I was on TV. Oh, yes. I was on TV more than TV. If you don't know what TV was, just go ahead and Google it, because I was there if you don't believe me. But before that, I have other life experiences, and to kill the time, I'll just it doesn't matter. I tell a good story. But most important of all, Berger was there. I first met Berger back in the day. It was one of those, I was at, his mother asked me, I was on the Carson Daly show, and they wanted Carson Daly to MC his bar mitzvah. And being that I was already a rabbi here, I knew. Excuse me. I need some more licorice. I love licorice. Okay, I bounce around to another story. Yeah, we stopped and we got licorice. I love licorice. You all know that. I got 6 pounds of licorice. That's in case we break down, we'll have 6 pounds of licorice. So 7 hours he live streams, 8 hours he live streams, the van makes it there, makes a noise, sounds like, oh my god, I keep saying, it's gonna break down, but no, the day, whatever, and then I have to follow him around, I'm tired, I'm an old man. Now I have to, here, I've gone all the way, like I said, from being on television to this day right now, where I'm sleeping in an old beat up van next to, yes, Berger, like I said, Berger. So, yes, I was in the porno industry. I was in retail. Well, wholesale to retail. Yes. Oh, yes, I sold videos. I worked at Times Square. I worked at 42nd Street when 42nd Street was like the Wild Wild West. We would get robbed sometimes 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times a day sometimes. There would be a line out there waiting for people to come in and rob us. And one night, a robber came in here and he took cuts in line in front of the other robbers who had been patiently waiting in line to rob us. The guy actually put a pistol to my head and cocked it. And I said, sir, you're going to have to get back in line and wait in line with the other robbers because we're overstaffed, understaffed today. My cousin Marty, who owns this place, he's with the staffing, sir. So I would appreciate if you got back in line. And he turned around and he actually, you can see, you can go back to 93 in the archives of the Daily News and see about the story, about the person that was, he shot somebody, I don't know, it goes on and on and on, and I was there for it, and like I said, I sold videos to the Bee Gees, and they liked the big breath videos. Oh, so we go on and on. I guess I'm still hanging out with the Berger. The Berger. If you people hate on the Berger, don't worry about the Berger. Because the Berger, I gave the Berger the Berger. The Berger the news. I know the Berger in personal. He's responsible for the little thingy there that he made some customs. The Berger would actually be a really good drummer if he wasn't trying to be a millionaire. He's going to be a millionaire on YouTube instead. Well, if he practiced a little bit, maybe he, I don't know, is... He's my friend, boys, and if you got, he's my friend in real life, so don't be saying stuff like he's going over there to, you know what, to re-up on something or something like that, okay, because he's not like that anymore, okay, boys? All right? I'd appreciate it if you guys would say, you blocked that guy right there for saying that. Yeah. Go ahead. Yeah, he was my rabbi. I went up in Hebrew school. My mom sent me there because, you know, I was, and when she said I... Like I said, he's a good boy. He's always been a good boy, and I've known him for quite some time. He used to play the ping pong for me, and I played ping pong for him, and we'd bet on burgers. And that's how he got his name, The Berger. Okay, thank you very much. Oy vey, went to go over here, crossing to Salancey or something like that, I don't know. Take a right up here. I said, take a right, take me over there, I got to do the re-up. I mean, I got to sell the... don't go there with that, sir.